What is going on, everybody? It's Hector Martinez once again for Urban Kung Fu. And hope you guys are having a great day today. It's actually Friday, and the weekend is finally here, which is a good thing. It's been a pretty busy week. Lots of responsibilities, lots of work. But you know, when Friday gets here, it's time to relax and to enjoy what we love to do. And today I'm bringing you one of my episodes based on one of my favorite films of all time, the one and only The Crow, starring Brenda Lee and written by James Zobar. You know, today actually is the premiere of the new Crow movie, which has gained a lot of controversy and a lot of talk, a lot of collectors and a lot of fans, and those who are enamored with The Crow are actually protecting the original from the new. You know, I'm giving the new movie the benefit of the doubt because it actually looks like a beautiful movie. The only thing is that I just don't see a connection with James Zobar's original story. But you know, that's okay. That's okay because we have only one Crow film, and it's the official Crow film and the only Crow film starring the late and great Brenda Lee. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, there is no other. They can make 10, they can make 20, they can make 30. But the original Crow with Brandon will always be the quintessential Crow film based on James Zobar's comic book. Today I want to talk to you about this very, very, very good book. I mean, you know, this is a type of book that you sit down and read, and you know that it's going to be so good that you're not even going to get up to take a break. You're going to stay glued to the pages. And that's exactly what happened to me with this this work of art by my friend, Miss Bridget Bass. And this is The Crow, the story behind the film. And this was published back in 2004, man, I can't believe it's been 20 years, wow. But you know, this book here, I actually read it at a time when I hurt my back pretty bad. I think I was doing a moving job or something and must have pulled some muscles and agitated some of my discs. And I was in excruciating pain. I could barely stand. I couldn't walk at all. So I took a couple of days off from work and stood home, and I had bought the book but had not started reading it. So that was a perfect time for me to really dig into this book by Miss Bridget Bass, The Crow, the story behind the film. I'm going to have to admit that this book is, you know, it's an eye-opener. For those that enjoyed the film and for those that have heard stories about all the things that happened in the movie and including Brandon's fatal accident, you won't know the true story behind it, the true facts in detail until you read Bridget Bass's book, The Crow, the story behind the film. I recommend this book to every serious Brenda Lee fan, every fan of the Crow. I mean, you've heard stories from different sources, but the thing that separates Miss Bass is the fact that she was welcomed into the Crow family. So she got to talk with the producers, those that work behind the scenes, the actors themselves. She got to interview lots of people, lots of key people involved with the film, and what Miss Bridget Bass got for us and put down in this book are facts about what went on with the Crow. A lot of mysterious things happen behind the scenes, and there is one part in this book that totally captivated me, and it's when Miss Bass shares with us that after Brandon's passing, the makeup department actually created a mask from Brandon Lee's original life cast. And they created a prosthetic mask and placed it on Brandon's double. And the mask was so realistically looking to Brandon's original features that it was as if Brandon came back from the dead. So when when Brandon's stunt double appeared on the set wearing that face prosthetic, the cast did not want to work with it. They did not accept it. Everybody was, I believe they were shocked because they knew that Brandon had passed. And to see someone look so much like Brandon, it was quite uncomfortable, I'm sure, for the cast and the crew. Especially those that were very, very close to Brandon. People like Sophia Shinas, who played Shelley Webster in the film. All the people that were close to Brandon, Jeff Omada, who was one of the choreographers and was also involved in the stunts, and a very, very good friend of Brandon Lee, Ernie Hudson, of course, who was the co-star of The Crow, and also Rochelle Davis, who played Sarah. So I'm sure a lot of these people felt quite uncomfortable seeing an actor, a stunt double, walking around with Brandon's face. I mean, it was quite shocking and indeed uncomfortable. So it's stories like that that are very intriguing. And there's so much material in this book, The Crow, the story behind the film. You can find this actually on eBay. You can also get it on Amazon. But you know what? Stay tuned, and I'm going to give you information on how you can obtain your own signed copy, personally signed to you from Ms. Bridget Bass. So you know what? We're going to get back to the details right after this. Okay, we are back, and here I have this is actually the hardcover copy of the Crow, the story behind the film by Miss Bridget Bass. And this one is the London edition. This is the English version. It's the same as the softback that I just shared with you, but this one is the hardcover version. And it's got a different cover. So, you know, we collectors enjoy that. We buy multiple magazines and from all over the world, multiple books, just because they have different covers. And this one does have indeed a really nice one. And as you can see, Miss Bridget was very kind enough to sign this here for me in silver Sharpie. So I appreciate that, Miss Bass. And you too can get your own copy if you're interested. And I will share with you the info on how you can obtain your own. So this one here is, again, the English version from London. And this is The Crow, the story behind the film, the hardcover version. So you can get yourself one just like this. Now, 20 years later, which is, you know, amazing when you think about it, time goes by so fast, Miss Bridget Bass did it again. And here we have the Crow, the life, death, and rebirth of a classic film. And this is Miss Bridget Bass's latest edition. This is what we call an, well, I would say a revised edition. It's upgraded beautifully because this one has additional information not in the original release, not in the first release. So this one, I recommend this highly because it's got so much more material. And not only that, but it's got a beautiful, beautiful center of color photos. So I recommend this highly. I also love the cover on this one. As you can see, it's got Brandon, and it's got the, it's a silhouette of the Crow mixed together, kind of like the 4K Blu-ray release, which has a combination of Brandon's face and the bird together. So this is nice on the cover of this book. I love it. The black cover with the red fonts, red lettering. And I think it's fantastic. And again, Miss Bridget was kind enough to sign that for me in silver Sharpie. So I wanted to mention that if you're interested in your own copy of the Crow, we have several for you. Drop me a message on Messenger on Facebook, and I, in exchange, will send you all the info that you need to order your own book. And Miss Bass will be kind enough to personally sign it to you. And I recommend it if you're a fan of The Crow. And it looks nice. I actually asked her to sign the front because like that, I could display it. And it looks nice inside of your display case or wherever you want to display your book. So these are the different versions. This one is the original, The Crow, the story behind the film. And this is the London version, the English version, which is the hardcover. And this is Miss Bass's latest edition, The Crow, the life, death, and rebirth of a classic film. So no Brandon Lee, no Crow fan should be without these guys. So highly recommend these for your reading pleasure and for display. Okay, once again, this is Hector Martinez for Urban Kung Fu. And I want to thank you all for tuning in. Want to wish you all a beautiful, healthy, and an exciting weekend. You guys take care out there. Stay safe and stay healthy. And until my next episode, all the best. Peace and God bless.
It's hard to